I could not think of a more fitting place for us to be gathered. This church, this gathering space, just a few blocks away from my house actually, is a source of so many powerful memories for me. And the reason for that is CABI, the Coalition to Abolish Death by Incarceration. It's hard to fully encompass what it's like to attend a CABI meeting, so the only word I will use is family. Every CABI meeting is a family gathering. There are hugs and daps, greetings and blessings, and a lot of yelling over each other, right? It's not a CABI meeting if somebody's not yelling over somebody. CABI feels like family because it is about family. It's about sons, brothers, cousins, uncles, family members through blood or chosen, family members that are no longer physically with us, family members that may spend the rest of their lives in prison. For years, organizations throughout Pennsylvania, like CABI, have fought and organized to end mass incarceration. I've been on the bus to Harrisburg with a lot of people in this room right now to call on the legislature to pass common sense legislation to reform our system. I've listened to the stories of mothers, daughters, and aunts who just can't understand why their loved ones can't come home. And for years, it felt as though our allies were far and few between. But standing before you today with the governor who is demonstrating his commitment to our cause, and finally, a Democratic majority in the House, right? That's right. I am hopeful that communities like ours will have a few more fighters in their corner. Governor Shapiro, I remember when you came here last year to listen to us. You listened as Ms. Didi spoke about how much she misses her son. You listened when people said we need to right the wrongs of our criminal justice system. And you being here today, making this important announcement of refusing to sign execution warrants, it shows that you're standing by your word. The death penalty is a grotesque relic of a bygone era. In a society dealing with so much senseless violence, the state should not be perpetuating this culture with violence of its own. And so that is why I'm here today to applaud Governor Shapiro for his actions and to call on the legislature to do the right thing and abolish the death penalty. And when we finally abolish the death penalty, let's move on to the vital work of ensuring that no one dies in prison.